Hey, what's up, guys? Kevin here. So today I bought the new T-Rise Pro snowboard. This is gonna be my next all-mountain freeride board. I bought it because, you know, I wanna carve and I also wanna do some freestyle stuff with it and also have the option to take it into the powder. But we have this entire series of boards to choose from Libtech and GNU. We'll get Andreas to take us through and see if I made the right choice on the T-Rise Pro. All right, so Andreas, did I make the right choice on the T-Rise Pro, man?
Well, Kevin, I think you made a really good call, and none of these boards are bad boards, so really it's just about making sure that you pick the right one for the right circumstance. I always start here. This is the Libtech Skate Banana, and this is the board that changed everything. Back in 2006, this was the first rockered snowboard that really hit mainstream and made rockered snowboards a thing. If you look at the tip and the tail of the snowboard are now lifted up off the ground. So it makes this board a lot easier to initiate a turn and to pivot. This type of board makes it a lot easier to initiate a turn, to spin into switch, to get the overall board to feel playful like a skateboard. So these are great for pressing, for turning, and for float in deeper snow, because you can imagine when you rear weight one end, the other end pops right up. The other cool thing that this board sort of started doing was the magnet traction. Libtech really started using magnet traction on the Skate Banana to give that looser, rockier feel, still some really good grip when you're on ice or when you're on hard pack.
The Skate Banana, much more suited for free ride, freestyle, sort of a jib board. So I feel like, yeah, that would have been my choice if I was looking for a park board. What's up next?
We've got the box knife. And the box knife's a cool one because it's sort of like a cross hybridization between two different boards that they were making before. This guy here is a cambered snowboard. So if we bring this board over to the same surface to compare the board that we just looked at that was rockered, and now put this one side by side, we can see that there's that gap in the middle. And that gap in the middle is the camber of the snowboard. This guy here, a lot more aggressive. You'll get a lot more pop out of the snowboard because it always wants to return back to that original cambered shape. So this is the guy that wants all of that fun, jibby playfulness, but maybe in a package that's a little bit tighter, a little bit more for that intermediate to advanced level rider.
So the box scratcher, more of like a jump board or like for more aggressive rails, higher speeds, that kind of thing?
Yeah, the person that really wants to load a jump, land a jump, who wants more power or more pop out of their snowboard. Not as loose, not as playful, not as forgiving either. When we look at the GNU headspace here, this is very similar to the box scratcher in the sense that it's their C3 aggressive camber. So you still get lots of pop out of this board. You still get a board that has that traditional cambered shape. Great for carving, great for stability, great for landing jumps. This one here has an asymmetry built in. So you can see it says heels here, which makes this board an asymmetrical specific board. The concept is that we have way more range of motion on our toes than we do on our heels. We kind of blindly lean back on our heels. So to give ourselves more power on our heel edge, they've actually just made the heel edge of the board slightly deeper. It's hard to see, and it's not something that you'll necessarily notice when you're riding it. It just feels intuitively more powerful on your heel.
The GNU headspace, definitely a more park-specific board. A bit more pop, so made for like hitting those bigger jumps, riding more aggressively. Let's continue on. Yeah, but what about this Skunk Ape? It's got this crazy graphic on it. It doesn't seem apparent, like, the differences between those boards.
Well, between the Skunk Ape and the T-Rise, they're very similar boards. They're actually of similar flex. The Skunk Ape is just slightly set back, making it a little bit directional. And the Skunk Ape is made really wide so that it fits people that have beyond 11 size feet. You know, if you're that guy that comes in and you've got that 12 or 13 foot, a Skunk Ape is an awesome board to go to because it's made wide. So you get just better power in your overall carving ability because you can lean the board over more. When we look at the TRS here, it's very similar to the T-Rise Pro. It's made a little bit narrower in the tip and the tail. So one could argue that it'll go edge to edge a little bit faster, being a little bit better for performance carving. When you compare the TRS to the T-Rise, it's not that they're, you know, one's better than the other. It's just that the TRS, you could argue, is a little bit better for hard pack, for getting from your heel edge to your toe edge really quick. A little bit narrower overall, so slightly better carving on piste. And then that T-Rice, a little bit wider in the tip and the tail, makes it better in the deeper snow. It floats a little bit better.
That was exactly what I was looking for too. Just a board that I could take into powder on those powder days, and something that I could carve with, get into some freestyle stuff, so.
What's your favorite graphic of the three?
Skunk Ape, I think.
Yeah, it's got a nice gloss.
It's pretty funky. I like the way they did the lib. So what about the Mule Air? I've heard like a lot of great things about the GNU Mule Air. TJ did a review on it. Compared to the T-Rice, how does it perform?
Well, the Mule Air is very specific to Nicholas Mueller's overall shape of snowboard. If you go back and if you look through Nicholas Mueller's different pro models, you'll see that a lot of them are sort of this type of shape. Camber in the back, blunted tail, and then really big front shovel to make it float really well when you're in deeper snow. The advantage to going to the Mervin construction now is that he's getting a little bit of that magnet traction. This guy here is blending together multiple different types of woods. So they use a Colombian gold core with Polonia. So you get a little bit of everything in this guy. They've really cross hybridized the different wood strains to give it the best flex pattern.
So a bit more of a powder leaning snowboard. Great for all mountain, but you know, with that fatter nose, a good option for powder.
Yeah, exactly. You know, it's gonna work great on hard pack for the person that wants to hard carve and charge. But then when you're in the deeper snow, you get that big front shovel and it really floats well. This is also a traditional cambered snowboard. So you still get normal camber throughout the back. And I think a lot of the, you know, the diehards, the old schoolers really like that camber. Just gives you a little more pop and a little more stability.
Probably more pop. It might be a little bit more difficult to float with that full camber compared to the T-Rise Pro, which has the rocker nose and tail, just a bit easier to float through the powder.
And a little more aggressive feeling overall. You're gonna find that this kind of board is gonna feel a little bit more hooky. It wants to be on one edge or the other. Versus your T-Rise, it's still a little bit easier to get that thing to plane around and get it to pivot.
Okay, so we're down to one of the last boards. This one is the LibTech Mayhem. This one looks like an absolute, like, just, yeah, powder machine, maybe similar to the Yes 420.
There's sort of been a big push to go to a shorter board that's been made wider so that it surfs really nicely and that it carves really hard still. Because it's made wider, you can really bring this thing onto edge. And because it's a little bit shorter, it wants to really arc a turn nice and quick. It feels super nimble. The top sheet on this guy is just absolutely gorgeous. Totally reminds you of Mount Doom. Imagine you're Mr. Frodo.
It's a beauty.
And Samwise Ganji is going to help you get to Mount Doom.
Perfect.
He's going to carry you. This is very similar to the Storm Chaser.
Same, like, fat nose, smaller tail, just a different sort of shape on the tail.
And then wider overall. Nice and surfy for sure. It sort of like fits into, you know, more of that quiver category, that board that maybe is a secondary board. Great for powder, great for turning. And it sort of bleeds into this story here. This guy is also what we would consider more of your powder specific, maybe quiver type board. This is the Spam. Even more specific to powder than the Mule Air would be. You would argue that this guy here, because it's got such a big front shovel, it's really gonna float nice in the deeper stuff. It's way more tapered, so it's gonna feel really turny when you're just riding it on hardpack. And then it does have a blunted tail that's designed to be much narrower than the front, so it's really gonna sink in the deeper snow. Still has that slight magnet traction on the edge for better grip when you're on ice, but this thing's designed for, you know, getting into the deeper stuff.
With these two boards, definitely powder specific, great for helping you float through the powder, through the trees. You can still ride them all mountain, get some carves going, but not the perfect carving board. And then the downside with these as well is they're not the perfect for riding switch, doing spins, like leaning more towards the freestyle stuff. Whereas the T-Rice, because it's that twin shape, it can still allow me to spin and kind of like have fun with the freestyle elements. All right, one board was hiding, the E-Jack Knife, Eric Jackson, pretty legendary rider from a lot of the Red Bull movies.
Yeah, this thing's awesome, man, and I love the graphic on it too. You know, this awesome fish guitar. Lots of people have been picking this up just because it looks so bloody rad. When you look at this guy, again, it's their C3 camber. and it's definitely a directional board. So you would argue that this guy sort of sits in along the same lines as the Mule Air, but the Mule Air is definitely a little bit more powder specific or big mountain specific. You would say that the E-Jack knife is more your everyday driver. It can really go everywhere. This is for the person that's maybe going to be on hardpack, maybe they're going to be in the park, maybe they want to be in a little bit of powder. This is great for that person who wants that hard arcing, powerful turn, the person that really wants to load up a nice big ollie, the person that might take this into bank slalom and really arc it around, do some Euro carving. This is great for the person who wants that classic camber feel, who wants that powerful, aggressive feel of camber that's always going to bring you to one edge or the other, and really just take you everywhere while remaining powerful and, you know, driven for speed.
So the Liptek E-Jack, built for somebody who wants to carve up the whole mountain, can take it into the powder as well. But yeah, just a bit more of an aggressive approach to snowboarding.
So one of the cool things about the T-Rice Pro is its hybrid platform. You can see that they try to give it a little bit of a diagram here, but essentially what it means is that there's rocker between the tip and the tail, or rocker between the feet for turning initiation and for float. You can see that rocker there making the board nice and loose and easy to pivot, easy to sort of bring around and switch. And also easy to get the board to float when you rear weight it. The cambered zones are actually under the inserts. But those cambered zones are still designed to give you that locked in feel, to still give you some power and some stability, and to still give the board some pop as well.
I feel like when I was riding this board, it was a great combination of like that catch-free nose and tail, but also the magnet traction really helped to grip it into the snow. So even though you got a bit of raise here, it definitely was backed up by the magnet traction.
Still felt super stable.
It did, yeah.
It's like a steak knife.
Exactly. We've gone through a big line of all kinds of different boards. After hearing Andreas really go through each one, from the park specific boards across to some all mountain and then into the powder, I feel like for what I was looking for, pretty confident with the T-Rice Pro. It's just that all mountain board that also has that freestyle ability, and I can take it into powder when I need to. So thanks, Andreas, man. Any final thoughts?
I think ultimately all of these boards are great boards, and you'd probably be happy with any of them, really. You'd be able to make do and make it work for you. But I think that that T-Rice is the best choice. I think it's the most versatile. I think it's really going to hold up well for your riding style, doing a little bit of everything, whether it be in the park, on hardpack, in the trees, or in the higher alpine.
Awesome, guys. So we'll put links to all these boards below if you want to check them out. Thanks again, Andreas, for taking us through this. Lots of fun. And we'll see you guys in the next video soon. Later, guys.